whole bunch of other stuff which even I don't remember. The teaching actually did not suddenly happen. I didn't wake up one day and say, I will start teaching tomorrow. When I was making my first film, I was in college. I was in college out of majboori. I couldn't study. I was a very bad student. I was terrible. My English was good. Good marks. History, geography, civics, all the subjects that required good English, good marks. Anything to do with numbers was scary. Physics was scary. Mathematics was scary. Geometry and algebra was extremely scary. When I was in the 10th standard, the principal called my parents and said, Mr. and Mrs. Vaswani, English 80 something, history, geography 85, 84, mathematics 4. How is he going to pass the ICSE? So my parents had no clue what to say. They said, we don't know. Then one army of teachers was put into action. Two tuitions before school, three tuitions after school, two tuitions extra over the weekend, three more on Sunday, two in the middle of the night. The teachers got fed up, nothing went into my head. And I decided I would go as far away from numbers and as far away from commerce and as far away from mathematics as I possibly could. I would go to the other end of the spectrum, and I thought films is the right place to go. Glamour, music, dance, acting, costumes, how wrong I was. It's only been about numbers for the last 40 years. It's only been about numbers. How much it will cost, how much do I sell it for, how much will it earn, how much will it not earn. Numbers, numbers, numbers. If I had known, I would have become a cook 30 years ago. This is the truth. But I did become a filmmaker. I had I started doing theatre, and then I started acting in ad films, and then I started doing television. I was in the first soap opera produced by Doordarshan. It was called Khandan. Your grandparents would remember it. It was quite ancient, like I am. And then when I was in school, it was in college when I produced my own television serial. It was called Nayi Dishaye. It was a story of a drug addict. I played the drug addict. I don't look like it, but I was very scrawny when I was young. And then someone I lost a bet with, there were some film children, Shami Kapoor's son, F.C. Mehra's son. And I had a fight with them. I said, you guys, you know, you people have been born in the film industry. Your father is Shami Kapoor. It said, somebody give me 5 lakhs, I'll make a movie. You people sit around and drink every night. What rubbish. Bravado. Nuksan ka hai. Bolne mein kya jaata hai. Next day they gave me 5 lakhs. They said, jao picture bana ke aao. I had a check. I went and showed my father. He pasted me very hard. He said, for heaven's sake, Vivek, give it back. Do you know how to make a film? I said, I learned. He said, how much does it cost? I said, I don't know. I learned. He said, give the check back. So next morning I was on my way to give this check back. But unfortunately, my friend Anant Balani, who was in school with me, called up. I said, hi Vivek. I said, hi Anand, what's up, where have you been? He said, I was at the film institute in Pune learning how to direct. I said, you direct a film for me, I don't have money, but you direct, I'll give you a break. He said, okay. Now I had 5 lakhs and I had a director. At that time I was doing theatre, I was acting in a play called Night of January 16th by Ayn Rand. And I said, whoa, this is set in a courtroom, one location. You don't have to go, you have to do nothing, you have to just get a bunch of actors, you have to make them sit in a courtroom and they talk. We can make this film in 5 lakhs. So I stole the script from the producer, Ronnie Sruvala. I got a friend of mine called Himendra Bhatia. I gave him 300 rupees and he translated it into Hindi in 3 nights. Now I had a script, a director and the 5 lakhs. That's called being creative. You can call it what you want. Anand Balani was from the Film Institute. His colleagues, Deepak Sehgal, Nagarajan, who had worked with him in the Film Institute, part of his team, said they will come in and shoot the film. So I had a DOP, I had an editor, I had a sound recordist. They were all Film Institute graduates. They'd never made a film before. But what difference does it make? Yeah, they have degrees. Surely they can do something. Kuch to seekha hoga film industry. So now I had a team and I had a script and I had a director. And I had the check. Then Night of January 16th is about two major protagonists. One lady, I was this young, I was really cute when I was 18. Go check out Khandan. I was outstandingly cute. Justin Bieber is ugly in front of me when I was 18. And I was charming. It oozed from every pore. And I sat in front of them and I took one look at their faces. I said, "Gaya, abhi kuch karo." Now be really creative. I mean, the art of being a producer is the art of being creative. I did the best thing. I started crying. I wept. And I said, "You all are stars. You guys have everything. I'm this 17 and a half year old kid who's bunking college to make a film. And you all are talking about money?" It's okay. We won't make the film. I'll get into the local train and get back home. I was wonderful. Zinnat said I could use her car anytime. Tanuja started bringing food from her house. Along with two little children called Tanisha and Kajol, who would land up on the set. They were that small. And we made Gawahi. And for 5 lakh rupees, I won my bet. And that started a career for Anant, for me, and for a whole bunch of people. I must tell you that it's the only film in the history of India that stars as actors two of the only directors in the Indian movie business who've been nominated for the Oscar, Shekhar Kapoor and Ashutosh Gawarikar. Ashutosh Gawarikar was my assistant. He had this huge mop of hair, you all won't believe. Huge, like a porcupine. And the moment he heard Zinnat Aman was acting in the film, he said, Vivek, I'm gonna act. I had to pay him also, he didn't have money to come to the set. Everyone worked free, Mr. Gawarkar got paid 700 rupees to act in the film. Took me over budget, but nonetheless. Subsequently, I made Patthar Ke Phool, in which I launched Raveena Tandon. Anand Balani directed that. My assistants on that film, apart from Ashutosh, were Sanjay Gupta, who's made Kante and who's made Kabil this year, Sanjay Garvi, who directed Dhoom and Dhoom 2, and a whole bunch of other people. Subsequently, Shah Rukh started staying in my house, I'll tell you about that in a bit. And when I made Raju Ban Gaya Gentleman, it was Jatin Lalit's first film, it was Shah Rukh's first film, it was Aziz Mirza's first film. I went on to making Atish, which was Sanjay Gupta's first film. I launched Atu Lagni Ho 3 in that. I went on to making Fantoosh, which was Iqbal Khan's first film. I made Sara Khopar, which was Dilip Joshi's first film. All of you know Dilip Joshi, he plays Tarak Mehta in some Tarak Mehta spectacles. Gyan Sahai was the debut director of that film. In 2002, I made Everybody Says I'm Fine, which was Rahul Bose's debut film, in which I launched Boman Irani and Rehan Engineer in Koel Puri and Anahita Oberoi and Rasool Mukherjee, the sound recordist who won the Oscar for Slumdog Millionaire. And by the time I knew it, half the industry had come somewhere through my films. And I realized possibly that I was a better teacher than I was a producer. And I decided that at some point, you know, years and years and years ago when I crossed 50, I decided it was time to start giving back. And I started teaching almost full time. Of course, I still make films. I still make about a couple of films a year. But the films are about education. The films are about kids. The films are about careers. And I think it is very important to start giving back, which is why this is what I do. I started by teaching at Shamak's Institute. Shamak was in school with me. He was a couple of years senior to me. He has an academy called the Shamak Dawal Institute. And there's also an NGO called the Victory Arts Foundation. And there's also Victory on Wheels. Those are outstanding dancers. They're not just good, they're outstanding. They can't walk because they're on wheelchairs. That's why it's called Victory on Wheels, but they're great dancers. Now, translating that dancing into careers is what I did. Translating Shah Rukh's acting into a career is what I did. Translating Ashutosh Gawarikar's penchant for acting into a great career as a director is what I had to do. So finally, my life was about careers, which is why I'm standing and talking to you today. Everything that you want to do becomes a career. Shah Rukh met me, I was shooting on Linking Road for Patthar Ke Phool. It was the last day of shoot. It was Raveena and Salman who were not recognized. Maine PR Kiya hadn't released yet. I was the one getting recognized because Khandan was on air and so on and so forth. So Ashutosh and Sanjay Gupta said, "Sir, go and sit in the corner. You know, you're creating a nuisance here. People are looking at you. We can't shoot. It'll cost you money." I went and sat in a little corner. There was this little coffee shop type place. And the waiter came and said, "Sir, There's a big TV star sitting there. He wants a cigarette. I looked and there was this Shah Rukh. I didn't know he was Shah Rukh. So I said, okay. Then the second cigarette. Then a third cigarette. Finally, he had the shame to come and ask for the fourth cigarette himself. Then I asked him if he wanted some anda and pav. He said, yes, he had three. Then they backed up shooting and I was on the way home. He said, where are you going? I said, well, it's a Sunday. Because you can only shoot in the road on Sunday and it's early enough. I'm going to the Sterling Cinema. They've installed something called Dolby. And I'm going to sit and I'm going to figure out how this Dolby business works. There's a James Cameron film. He said, I'll come. I said, come. It was houseful. I paid for the tickets in black. I paid for the popcorn. I paid for the fresh cigarettes. At 1 o'clock in the night when I came out from the cinema, he said, can you give me 100 rupees? I have to go back to Bandra. I didn't have 100 rupees, you know. I was spending, in those days we didn't have credit cards and stuff. So I said, okay, no worry, get into my car, I'll drop you home. I didn't have gas that day, coincidentally. I said, okay, no problem, come home with me. My mother has got insomnia. She doesn't normally sleep before 2 o'clock in the morning. We'll take some money from her, you can go home. That day she slept early. So I said, all right, you know, you can have a pair of shorts and you can sleep and then tomorrow morning you go. He stayed 2 years. And I had to make Raju Bangia judgment for him, which gave the industry ulcers because they rejected Patthar Ke Phool because who was I to launch someone called Salman Khan? 14 financiers rejected Patthar Ke Phool. New boy, new girl, new producer, new director, etc., etc. And then subsequently when GPCP said he would fund it and we made it into a super hit, all those 14 people came back and said, make your next film with Salman. I said, no, I'm making it with another guy called Shah Rukh. They rejected me all over again. I think by now they're fed up of rejecting me. Careers. I had a cousin called Rishi. One answer.
You earn money.
Yeah.
If you're a professional, you earn money.
If you're a professional, you get paid to do that. Yeah. That's what I mean. You don't necessarily make money, but if you're an actor, you act. If you're a professional actor, you get
paid
to act. So he said, oh, okay, then I want to be a professional actor. I said, no, you'll change your mind when I ask you the next question. By then he was wary enough. So I said, do you want to be a professional actor or do you want to be a successful professional actor? It's two separate careers. There's a hell of a lot of people in the film industry who have a great career by being unsuccessful professional actors. Viju Khote. He played Kalia in Sholi. Kitne aadmi the, do sardar. You all don't know his name. It's Viju Khote. He's been acting in films for the last 40 years. When you see his face, you'll say, ah, we saw him in this, or we saw him in that, or we saw him in this. But for 40 years, consistently, he's been acting. He's been getting an income. Maybe 5,000 rupees a day, or 10,000 rupees a day, or 20,000 rupees a day, and he acts for 10 days or 15 days in a month. He makes his 2-2.5 lakh rupees a month. It's a 25 lakh rupee annual package. That's more than a middling level executive earns in any corporate company. It's an income. He's not a successful professional actor. He's not Boman Irani or Anupam Kher, you know, who gets 40 lakhs or 50 lakhs or 60 lakhs for a film. He's unsuccessful by money standards, but it's a career. So, we said, do you want to be an actor? Do you want to be a professional actor? Do you want to be a successful professional actor? So, he looked and said, okay, I want to be a successful professional actor. I said, you'll change your mind when I ask you the next question. He said, don't ask me. I said, I have to. You're living in my house. And you're not going away. He said, ask. I said, do you want to be a successful professional actor or do you want to be a star? What's the difference? What's the difference between a successful professional actor and a star?
With being a star, you get fame and popularity. You get popular.
Nasiruddin Shah is a successful professional actor.
But when you are a star, it becomes a star.
What's the difference in the job profile?
A star becomes a brand.
What's the job profile? You know, when you have to fill up a form and you say description of job, actor, this is the star, this is the description. What is the job profile? This is the most critical question. If you can take this home with you, you've achieved a lot. Let me explain. Arguably, arguably, one of the finest actors in the country would be Nasiruddin Shah. Undoubtedly. One of the finest actors, one of the successful actors, one of the most professional actors I know is Nasiruddin Shah. 50 lakhs a film. Arguably, the biggest star in the country is Salman Khan. 50 crores per film. The finest actor in the country gets 1% of the salary of the biggest star in the country. 1%. If the jobs were the same, why isn't the salary the same? Because the jobs are not the same. There's no parity. 50 lakhs, 50 crores. So obviously what I pay Mr. Shah to do is not what I pay Mr. Salman Khan to do, right? What's the difference? So, since we don't have time, otherwise I would love to tantalize you and I'm a great talker. I pay Mr. Shah to give me a performance, bluntly. I pay Mr. Salman Khan to make me a profit, no more, no less, regardless of his performance. Nasir better be good. That's what he's charging me for. Salman better make me a profit. That's what he's charging me for. Salman comes late, I don't care. He doesn't know Hindi, somebody will dub for him. He can't remember lines, I'll write them on a blackboard. He wants to delay shooting by a month, I'll wait. If he can't sell tickets, I don't want him in my film. Salman makes me a profit not with his performance, but with his signature on the contract. Even before, a year before I start shooting, I've already sold the film to a Warner Brothers or an Eros or Reliance. I've already taken the money, I've already put in the bank, I'm earning interest, I'm parting with him while we decide what the script will be. It's two separate jobs. Unfortunately, in my profession, in the film business, thousands of children are coming to Bombay. They're joining all sorts of acting classes.